Hey, good day, good day, good day, good day. Hey, thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining me. Just in case you're joining me for the very first time, I'm your host, the one they call Brian Glaze Gibbs. This is my ministry. This is my life. Right now, I am not your typical minister. What I'm going to talk about, I'm going to talk about the good. I'm going to talk about the bad. I'm going to talk about the ugly. But the most important thing, what I'm going to talk about is right now is life experience. Things that I've been through, hopefully by me sharing these things that I've been through, my experience, somebody can listen and understand where did I went wrong or where did some of the people that used to be associated with me went wrong. You know what? Get your signed copy. What I want you to do is order your signed copy of the Brian Glaze Gibbs book. Okay? Beyond Lucky, the Brian Glaze Gibbs story, Crack, Money, Murder, and Redemption, by emailing me, Brian, B-R-I-A-N, Gibbs, G-I-B-B-S, 1201@yahoo.com. If you place your order for your signed copy, I will send you Straight from the Street Volume 1 or Straight from the Street Volume 2 audiobook for free. Now, what I'm going to talk about is, here it is, today, the month of July. The month of July right now is, if my little friend, my old associate, my buddy, 50 Cent, the original 50 Cent, if he was still alive, right now, he'd have been celebrating 57 years of existence. Okay? Sit back and think about it. Here it is, he died, and he became who he became by the time he was 23 years old. But yet and still, he already been gone 34 years, and his name still ring as F. He never left. Let's sit back and reflect back upon this individual. You know what? When you sit back and you think about it, he was a little guy, a little short dude. About 5'2", okay? Probably weigh like a buck 10 maximum, okay? But yet and still, he was able to cause havoc. He was able to cause so much agony towards people. Why is that? Okay, if you look at it and you sit back and you think about it, it seems like most short dudes, okay, have little man complex. Look at Napoleon, little man complex. So the difference is, here it is, no different than him. What he wanted, I don't care how big I am, y'all gonna respect me. And you know what, for the most part is this, you're supposed to treat people like people. It doesn't matter if they shape, size, colors, you know what I'm saying, form, it doesn't matter. Respect is respect. In order for you to get respect, you have to give respect. So a lot of times people look at you, or they will, or they won't give you a prop. And sometimes you have to go way and beyond to get people, you know what I'm saying, to respect you. You have to do something crazy. Go upside somebody's head for them to respect you. So being that he had that little man complex, he always felt he had something to prove. He always felt he had to do certain things to let people know that he meant business or whatever. Not saying that it was always right in what he did. You know, my relationship with him was totally different. Because to me, like I told you, I knew him as a kid. You know, right now, was I was fortunate to meet him. I think he was 6 and I was 7 on Horsey Street. Okay, in the Bedford-Stuyvesant section. He had family members that live on Horsey Street. You know, I believe, you know, Pop, you know what I'm saying, Michelle, Cannon, you know, Belinda. So right then, my family, we grew up on Horsey Street a few blocks down. So during, like most of the summertime, you know, when we was there and we was in down south, we played together. And we got to build a relationship with one another. So that don't mean anything because even as we got older, we still was close. And then right now is, guess what? A lot of times people do not understand. You know, like to me, he can spy. He tried to set me up to get my head taken off. I didn't understand, but the difference was he set up a move. And that move that he set up, he wound up saying something to the wrong person. And once he says something to the wrong person, that person returned, went back to the party that was involved. And basically, look, man, this is what 50 Cent tried to do. He trying to set this move up for glazing him. Keep in mind, I was nowhere around. I was nowhere around. I was in jail, fighting a murder charge. So what do I have to lose? I didn't have a thing to lose. So my objective is I'm facing life anyway. My so-called buddy, 50 Cent, came to me with one of these plans that's gonna help me get some more paper into my pocket as I fight my case and possibly have to go upstate and serve a life sentence. So he came to me with an offer that I could not refuse. But just so happened, that move never happened because it got nipped in the bud. Now, when I get acquitted and I came home, I'm hanging out with 50. I'm hanging out with his brother. Me and this brother right now, is he came pick me up. He's driving his gold Jetta with his BBS rims. And first thing, we stopped. He came to Cypress, picked me up. And then right now, next thing you know, we downtown. I forgot. I don't even know whether that pawn shop is still down there or whatever. I guess it's in that area where they got the new Barclays Center. We down there. We hanging out in the jewelry store, pawn shop or whatever, you know what I'm saying, period. We was probably there for like an hour, okay? Next thing you know, we left there. Next stop, okay, the Fort Greene. We down in the Fort Greene section, okay? We there for hours, okay? Keep in mind, I don't got no gun. I don't got no bulletproof vest. I'm with my man, all right? Not knowing, you know, when we's there, what he did was he made a phone call. And, you know, he paid somebody. They called him back. And he told him, look, me and Glaze right here, we in the Fort Greene Projects. He don't got no gun. He don't got no vest. Okay? I don't know this. All right? I'm still hanging out with my so-called friend. All right? Next thing you know, guess what? We left. We left Fort Greene. And we went to the Albany Project. Okay? Now we in the Albany Project. They start playing dice. Gambling. Okay? Here it is. Didn't know it again. He went to the payphone. Paid somebody. Look, I got Glaze right here and Albany Projects. He don't have no vest. He don't have no gun. We can get him. Whoa, I didn't know that. But what happened is, I know I've been out too long. I know that despite I felt during that period of time, I could have went anywhere and be good. And I was good. And basically, as he was trying to line me up, these individuals, as I found out later, as they told me, listen, man, everywhere you was, he wanted to line you up. He called us, let us know you was there, and you was right. And we didn't want you. You know, he the one that brought you that thought, that opportunity, that, you know, you can make money by doing this, by going against us. So you was not the target. So like I told you, when I found out about that is, I was irate, I was upset. And you know what, I found out about that before he even died. And even when he died, you know what, like I said right now is, I didn't have, like, you know, that's my man. Okay, I regret that he died. But the difference is I had mixed emotion. You know, say, okay, cool. You know, sometimes you can love somebody, but sometimes you can love people more than they love you. And if right now this guy loved me the way he say he loved me, why would he be trying to set me up to die? And folks, listen, the moral of the story is this, man. Guess what? I don't care who you are, what you are. Remember, man, always be true to yourself and follow your instinct. Always follow your instinct. Even with him, like I tell you right now, is if he was still alive, hopefully he would have been able to change his life like me and got himself together and been living a law-abiding, productive life as a grown man, you know, being with his kids, his grandkids. Because once again, like I told you right now, he wasn't all bad. I'm saying he wasn't all bad. He was a good guy. We just had a lot of effed up ways. And you know what? Trauma. A lot of us were traumatized at a young age. And you know what? We didn't know how to get past that. We didn't know that we were traumatized. We didn't know and understand why we were so angry. You know, and trust me, if he would have figured out like I have figured out, I think he would have been a great law-abiding citizen right now. And you know what? Probably could have been with me right here, you know what I'm saying, talking about stuff, talking about where we went wrong, admitting like, you know what, we was idiots, you know, trying to talk to the young people now, like, listen, man, that's not cool, that's not the way to be. Listen, hit that like button, subscribe, one love.